Hi, hello friends. I am Professor Vaghmadi Bihar. Today we will discuss the topic on crop production technology of cotton. First of all, we can see the botanical name of cotton, that is Gossypium species. Family belongs to that is Malvaceae. Origin, that is from India. Then next point, that is geographical distribution. Here we can see the in case of cotton, the major countries which will cultivate the cotton, that is Russia, USA, China, India, Brazil, Pakistan, Turkey, then Egypt, then Mexico and Sudan are the major cotton growing countries. In India, is the largest cotton producer, followed by the USA and the China. The average productivity of cotton in India is lower than the Russia. In India, the cotton is cultivated in Maharashtra, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Rajasthan, Haryana, then Karnataka, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Orissa and Uttar Pradesh. Among the states, Maharashtra ranks first in terms of the area and production of cotton, followed by the Gujarat and the Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh. Next point, that is the economic importance. As being cotton is a cash crop or the important commodity in the national economy, it helps to be also the improving the international or national level economic development, and then also the industrial commodity. As first you can see here, the economic importance, cotton is also called as the white gold, is one of the most important commercial or the cash crop. Then it plays an prominent role in national and international economy. In cotton is also called as the king of fiber crop among the all fibers, fiber crops, especially in the industrial commodity. And it is the one of the most important commercial crop, playing key role in the economic affairs of the world. And it is chiefly grown as a fiber, and it is used for the manufacturing of the cloth. The oil content in the cotton seed ranges from 15 to 25. Percentage that is the depending on the different varieties. Then American cotton having the highest oil percentage than the other varieties. It may be Desi or the Egyptian cotton. Then raw cotton is also the used for the medical and surgical purposes. Then it is used for the manufacturing of high grade paper, films and the explosives. Then the stock is used as for the fuel making purpose and the cultivation of the mushrooms, as well as the as a waste material. And cotton seed cake is also the good serve as the concentrated feed for the cattle, and also used as a good manure, and also contains about good quantity of the nutrients. This is the economic importance of cotton. Next one, you can see the importance of cotton in the world trade. As the cotton is the essential commodity, or especially used in the national economy, international economy development, as the cotton is grown as the commercial or the important cash crop, as grown in all over world, it helps to be improving the world economy. Here we can see the cotton is the essential produce for its fiber, which is universally used as a textile raw material. Then cotton is important commodity in the world economy. Then grown more than 100 countries, cotton is heavily traded as agricultural commodity, with over 150 countries involved in the export or import of the cotton. And cotton is also very political crop, because its importance in the world trade and as to be economies of the many developing countries. And the many countries, cotton export not only are a vital contribution to foreign exchange earning, but does account to the significant proportion of the gross domestic product, that is GDP and the tax income. Next one, you can see the classification of cotton. There are major two types of cotton, that is desi cotton, that is deployed species, and the this is also called as the old world cotton. This chromosome number is 2n is equal to 13. There is Gossypium arboreum, then Gossypium herbaceum are the species which will be categorized under the desi cotton. Then new world cotton, that is popularly known as the American cotton, having the chromosome number 2n is equal to 26. And then there are different species. There is Gossypium barbadens. This is also this is a sea Iceland cotton, and especially grown as or is main character of this Gossypium barbadens. This is a long staple cotton, and the Gossypium hirsutum. This is a American cotton. This is highest area under cultivation. India is the only country can cultivate the all types of the cotton species. That is the Gossypium arboreum, Gossypium herbaceum, then Gossypium barbadens, then Gossypium hirsutum. This is a classification of cotton. Next one, the soil and climate, that is ecological conditions required for the cotton cultivation. That is first one, soil. Cotton being a deep rooted crops, it requires the best suited soil, that is black cotton soil. So clay soil or the black soil is called black cotton soil, because this is the best suitable for the cotton cultivation, because the black soil having the deep soil profile layers, and the cotton is a deep rooted crops is helpful for the growth and development. That's why it is a black soil is also called as the black cotton soil. And the cotton can successfully grown especially in all types of soil. It may be sandy soil, saline soil, or waterlogged soils. Then it can be grown on the all types of soil. Then certain needs fertile soils with the good moisture or the water holding capacity. And the soil should be good aeration and the drainage conditions. And the pH range should be 6.5 to 8.5. Next one, the climate. Cotton is a tropical crop. It requires hot and humid climate, also requires warm weather. The minimum temperature, that is 20 to 26 degrees Celsius required for germination, and the 21 to 27 degrees Celsius for the proper vegetative growth. During fruiting period, temperature required, that is a bowl form is doing for bowl formation. The temperature required, that is 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. During ripening, the fruiting period, heavy showers of the rains may result in the shedding of the flower and the young bowls formation. And cloudy weather and the high temperature as well as the high humidity tends to result the increase the attack of the sucking pests. This is a major criteria, especially climatic requirement for the cotton crop cultivation. Next one, the varieties and hybrids. Among the varieties, especially in the desi cotton or the is called as the irrigated cotton, there are different varieties and hybrids. AKH 4, that is the hybrid one, especially grown under the irrigated conditions, the categorized in desi cotton. Then AKH 5, then AKA, this is a variety, popular variety of desi cotton or irrigated cotton, that AKA 84001, then Jyoti. Next one, the American cotton is also grown, especially grown under the rainfed condition, is also called as rainfed cotton. The varieties are MCU4, MCU5, MCU7, then Dhanlakshmi, then PK Virajat, then SRT1, then DHY. This is a hybrid one, especially in the American 286, that is DHY 286. Then BT cotton varieties, there are different varieties, MRC 7347, then this is a Bolgard second. Then MRC 7351, Bolgard second. MRC 7365, Bolgard second. Then MRC 7377, this is also Bolgard second, this is a BT cotton varieties. And then hybrids, especially the popular hybrids of cotton, that is DCH32, then MECH1, FOLA388, then PKV hybrid 2, then Varalakshmi, this is the first intraspecific hybrid developed by the University of Agriculture Sciences, Dharwad. Then this is the world first hybrid of cotton developed by Dr. C.D. Patel, then S6, then H8, then S10. That is H4 is the world first hybrid of cotton developed by Dr. C.D. Patel. This is also some photographs regarding the important varieties and hybrids. That is Fule 492, then Fule 688, then Fule Anmol, then H4. This is the first hybrid of cotton. Then Fule 388, then Varalakshmi. This is the first intra-specific hybrid. Then Fule Rupmai, then Fule Yamuna, then Fule Dhanvantari. This is a varieties developed by MPQ Rahuri. Next point, that is the father of the hybrid cotton. This is a higher technology of initiation of the hybrid production, especially in cotton. That is Dr. C.T. Patel. This is first world scientist who discovered or developed the world first hybrid, that is H4. Hence, it is called, he is considered as the father of hybrid cotton. Then, firstly, developed the BT cotton, that is Dr. C.D. Mai, that is who is considered as the father of BT cotton. And then Dr. C.D. Mai was the former chairman of Agriculture Scientist Recruitment Board, that is located in New Delhi. In BT cotton, the gene of Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria is introduced for the minimizing the attack of bollworm complex, that is spotted bollworm, then pink bollworm, then American bollworm. These are the three types of the bollworms which are against the development of the BT cotton for the especially resistance to this specific species by the transmitting or inserting the gene, that is from Bacillus thuringiensis. In BT cotton, the Cry1AC gene is used for the introducing the in cotton plant for minimizing the attack of bollworm, that is Cry1AC. This is a gene which is introduced in cotton plant for minimizing the attack of bollworm complex. The Cry1AC gene is isolated from BT, the Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria, introducing in the cotton plant for minimizing the attack of bollworm. This Bacillus thuringiensis is a gram-positive soil-dwelling bacterium. The bollworm resistance to first generation of this BT cotton was identified in the Australia, then China, in Spain, and in United States. This is a detailed information regarding the BT cotton. Next one, that is cropping systems followed in the cotton. As in crop rotation, cotton is grown as a previous crop. After harvesting of the previous crop, that is cotton, next season crop, that is rabi, wheat, then barsim, then chickpea, then linseed. Then intercropping systems, that is cotton, that is crops, two or more crops are grown simultaneously on the same piece of land over a same period of time. That is cotton with cotton being a non-legume along with the grown, that is intercrop, that is belongs to family leguminaceae, that is a legume crop, legume non-legume combination. This is a perfect and the successful intercropping system, that is especially in cotton. The suitable intercrops, that is green gram, then black gram, then groundnut, then soybean, then also pigeon pea. This is a successful intercropping systems, especially in the cotton. Then field preparation. Cotton being a deep-rooted crops, it requires 2 to 3 deep plowings, followed by 3 to 4 harrowing operations are to be made for the ideal seed bed. Generally, cotton crop can be grown in the resistant furrow, then also the paired row system, and then also the in border strip method. Next one, the seeds and sowing. The seed rate required for the rain fed or American cotton and or the PT cotton are to be 15 to 25 kg per hectare, and then irrigated or desi cotton it requires 10 to 18 kg per hectare. Then hybrids, it is only 5 to 6 kg because of the hedge growth of plants, and then the branching and the reproductive growth is more versus the other species, the desi or the American cotton. Then spacing required for the American or the rain-fed cotton or the BT, that is 60 by 45 cm, and for desi or irrigated cotton it requires 60 by 30 cm, and the hybrids requires, that is 60 by 60, because of the hedge growth of plant and branching numbers, then reproductive or the vegetative growth is more over the other species. That's why the spacing is required for the hybrids, that is wide. And then sowing time for the rain-fed or American or BT cotton, that is in month of May to June. Then irrigated or desi cotton, that is March to April, and the hybrids, that is June to July. Next one, the seed treatment is specially followed in cotton, that is a concentrated S2SO4, that is sulfuric acid treatment. This treatment is given before the sowing of seed, especially the fuzzy seeds which having the fibers, which will be killed by the treating the seeds with the concentrated S2SO4 or burning the fibers present on the seed with the help of S2SO4 with the range from 70 to 100 cc per kg of fuzzy seed. Fuzzy, that is the fiber. Then it helps to be remove the fiber or the fuzz of the cotton seed, and also soften the seed coat, helps to the improving the germination of cotton seed. Then defuzz or delinting seed is easy to be sow, or it will be germinate rapidly. That's why this is a very recommended treatment for especially in cotton. Then with respect to the farmer, the cow dung paste slurry, this is the most suitable and the most adaptable, easily adaptable to the farmers. If the chemical is not available, then the seed should be rubbed with the paste made of cow dung, ash and water and dried in the shade. Then after that, you have to treat the seeds with the fungicide, that is fungicide treatment. Seeds are treated with the fungicides like the Thyram or Captan at the rate of 3 gram per kg of seed. Helps to be prevent the seed as well as soil borne diseases. Then biofertilizer treatment before sowing, cotton seeds are treated with the Azotobacter or Azospirillum at the rate of 25 gram per kg of seeds. Helps to be enhance the atmospheric nitrogen fixation by non-symbiotically as well as the germination of crop. Next one, the intercultural operations followed in cotton. Especially cotton, there are the two important operations, that is gap filling and thinning. As we know, the gap filling is the whatever the gaps was found, the seeds, either by the seeds or the seedlings, will be grown whenever the gaps was found. This operation should be carried out immediately after the 10 to 15 days after sowing, and this operation is to be carried out for the maintaining the optimum plant population. In these operations, you have to use the seeds whenever the gaps was found. Then next one, the thinning operation, that is removal of the extra growth of the seedlings, or the maybe disease affected or the insect damaged seeds, the seedlings should be removed instead of the healthy one. And this operation is to be carried out after 10 to 15 days after sowing. The main objective of this thinning and the gap filling operation, that is to maintain the optimum or desired plant population. Next one, the manures and fertilizer, the nutrient requirement for cotton, especially for cotton is a heavy feeding crop or more demanding, especially for the nutrients. Hence, it should supply 15 to 20 tons of FOM per compost at the time of final land preparation or before 1 month of sowing. Then recommended dose of fertilizer, that is 140-60 kg NPK per hectare. As the nitrogen should be applied as a half dose of during the sowing operation, and the remaining dose of the P and K should be applied, that is in full dose, at the time of sowing. Then remaining half dose of nitrogen should be applied at the time of flowering and the square formation stage. Then additional dose of the 60 kg should be applied at the time of flowering as well as the bowl formation. Helps to be enhance the quality of fiber and the fiber strength. Next one, the water management. The cotton being a Kharif season crop, if the rains are received sufficient, and then there is no need of irrigation. If the rains are not received, then supply irrigation at the critical growth stages. As the critical growth stage, especially in cotton, that is early growth stage, then flowering stage, then square formation, then the bowl formation. Among all stages, the critical or very sensitive stage for irrigation, that is the square formation stage. Then cotton requires total or average number of irrigation, that is 5 to 6, to complete its growth and development. And then weed management, the cotton is highly sensitive to crop weed competition with the initial stage of growth. Hence, the weeds can be controlled either by the manual or by the herbicides. That is, recommended practices will be followed for the control of weeds, that is to hoeing and the followed by 4 to 5 weeding operations is necessary for control of weeds and some of the herbicides, that is fluclorine or diuron or the alachloride, at the rate of 1 kg active ingredient per hectare in 1000 liter of water, could be used as a pre-plant incorporation sprays. Then use of hormones, especially in the cotton, it will be helpful for the improving the reproductive growth instead of the vegetative. Hence, there need to be a spray the or use the plant modifiers like the NAA, then Cycocel. Helps to be more body retention, then bring early reproductive growth stages and the better bowl formation. Then spraying of the NAA, that is 125 cc per hectare at flowering appearance or the flowering initiation. Then second spray of 175 cc per hectare helps for the better bowl formation. And the spraying of the Cycocel at the rate of 32 ml per hectare dissolved in 320 liter of water at the square formation retain the more number of the bowls on the plants. This is the use of hormones, and this is necessary for the especially cotton to get the more number of bowls, bowl size, then especially flower numbers, then square numbers. Next one, the plant protection, especially in cotton, there are a huge number of the pest attack, that is the especially in the bollworm complex, which will be infested the cotton heavily. That is being pink bollworm, then spotted bollworm, then American bollworm. These are the three main types of the bollworm, which will be affect the crop heavily. Then followed by the sucking pest, that is aphids, thrips, whiteflies, then cotton leaf roller. This is also the major pest, and red cotton bug. This is also called the cotton stainer. Especially this red cotton bug will be attack on the fiber growth or fiber formation stage, which will be also called as the cotton stainer. Then control measure for the different bollworm complex as well as sucking pest, especially in cotton, that is should follow the integrated pest approach. That is spraying of dimethoate 30 EC at the rate of 1 liter in 1000 liter of water per hectare. Then spraying of the endosulfan 35 EC at the rate of 150 liter in 1000 liter of water per hectare. Then spraying of malathion 30 EC at the rate of 1 liter in 1000 liter of water per hectare, and growing the early varieties, then collect and destroy the pest infected plant parts, and then growing of the BT cotton also. Also, the install the sticky traps, it may be yellow or the blue color, yellow sticky traps per acre, that is average 5 yellow sticky traps to be installed, and then also the pheromone trap, then light traps are to be used for attracting the pest, especially the bollworm complex or the sucking pest. This is a control measures against the cotton pest. Next one, the diseases, especially in the cotton, there are different types of diseases. There is root rot, fusarium wilt, then anthracnose, then bacterial blight, and the leaf spot. Among the diseases, major disease, there is fusarium wilt and the root rot. If the field is will be excess water condition or water logging conditions, it will be affect the crop plants through the root rot or the fusarium wilt. Then for also the anthracnose, bacterial blight, leaf spot. This disease can be controlled with the help of the treat the seeds with fungicide, that is agromycin or thyrum or captan or bivestin. Especially agromycin, that is 100 milligram in liter 1 liter of water. Then treat the seeds with thyrum and captan at the rate of 3 gram per kg of seeds. Then spray the crop with mycozeb at the rate of 1 liter 800 to 1000 liter of water per hectare, then grow resistant varieties also. Next one, the harvesting and yield. Especially in cotton, the harvesting can be done with the help of by means of the picking operation. As the bolls matures, the kapas or the fibers are hanging down, then should start the picking operation. Especially cotton is harvested within 3 to 4 pickings by hand. As the boll matures, and the cotton should be picked clean and dried to get a good price in the market. This is a important criteria for especially the cotton, so that is to get good price when the cotton should be fiber or the kapas should be clean and dried. Then crops should be ready for first picking in the by the middle of October, and the second picking in the month of November, and third picking is the last week of November, and the last, that is fourth one, in the month of December. The picking should be done when the balls begins to burst and the when the kapas begins to hang down, and then collect the kapas or cotton should be spread in the sun for dry, and then do not keep picked cotton or kapas or fiber in the wet water channel in the field, and they remove all debris like the leaves, stems or the branches as well as the soil that are impairs the quality of cotton. This is the detail regarding the harvesting of cotton. Then final yield is in case of the cotton that is 15 to 20 quintals per hectare, especially in the desi cotton or irrigated cotton, and 20 to 25 quintals per hectare that is for American and the or the rain-fed or BT cotton, and 25 to 30 quintals per hectare that is for the hybrids. That is highest yield will be observed that is from the hybrids because of the more growth, especially the reproductive or the boll formation, the size of the boll. That's why the yield of this hybrid one is the highest than the other species of the cotton. This is today's lecture about the crop production technology of cotton. Thank you.